The beautiful country Venezuela. Venezuela is officially known as the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela and is situated at the northern coast of South America. Venezuela is bordered by Brazil on the south, Colombia on the west, and on the east border Guyana can be found. It is the 33rd largest country with a land area of over 882,000 square kilometers and a total area of more than 916,000 square kilometers. Venezuela falls into four horizontal temperature zones: temperate with dry winters, tropical, dry, and polar climates. These are based on the elevation. Venezuela lies within the neotropical ecozone. Much of the land in Venezuela is protected, as we can see. The largest protected area is Bolivia. Here in Bolivia we find the Canaima Nature Reserve. This is the second largest park in Venezuela and the sixth largest park in the world. This majestic national park is home to the magical Angel Falls. This park alone is the size of Maryland or Belgium. The park is famous for its Mount Roraima, which is the tallest and easiest pile to climb. The national park has remained relatively remote with very little roads, thus very little land has been transformed. The Amazonas is also one of the largest protected areas found within Venezuela. This comes as no surprise as the Amazonas poses some of the world's most beautiful land. Here we would find tropical rainforests, savannas and mountains. The Amazonas is also home to the birthplace of the world's third largest river, the Orinoco River. Here we find the Delta Amacuro, which also falls under the protected areas. But this protected area also includes the Orinoco River, same as the Amazonas. Much of this large river seems to be in protected areas. The Orinoco River meets the Atlantic Ocean and deposited so much sediment along the years that it has formed the Orinoco Delta. The Orinoco Delta is 40,000 square kilometers in area. This ecoregion consists of 60 waterways and 40 rivers. These rivers and waterways have created mixed tropical rainforests, swamps, river islands, and even mangroves. This delta is home to many of the country's endemic species. It's easy to see why this area needs protection, as it not only houses many ecosystems and their species, but is also one of the world's most pristine wetlands. We see many separate protected areas here, but as can be seen in Tujula and Merida, we also find that there are many corridors linking various protected areas. Not much of the land in Los Llanos is protected. This could be due to many of its areas being transformed. The Los Llanos is also known as the Plains and is a vast tropical savanna with forests along creeks and rivers. The extreme climate found here results in flooding in many parts of the Llanos, creating many temporary wetlands. These wetlands become watering holes for the birds and animals during the hot, dry seasons. This plain is home to hundreds of animals ranging from anacondas, giant anteaters, to pink dolphins. For the purpose of this video, we will be looking at the systematic conservation approach to locate, design and manage protected areas in Venezuela. We will be using the maps and model to determine the best conservation plan at the minimal cost. Now we will take a look at the beautiful species found within Venezuela. Pyrura hematotus. Although this endemic species has a small range, it is not considered as approaching the thresholds for vulnerability. It is listed as least concern under the IUCN threatened list. The IUCN uses a criteria assessment to establish where the species are under threat, and according to those criteria, this species does not meet the criteria to be deemed vulnerable. This population of the species is decreasing, but not at a rate which is alarming. Diglossa venezuelensis is restricted to the northeast mountains of Venezuela, which makes them endemic to the country. These birds are found in montane habitats, secondary forest and second growth scrub. This beautiful bird is currently endangered and found only in protected areas. The activities that have led to them becoming extinct is primarily due to the land degradation, burning and understory removal in forests. The coffee plantations has had a huge impact on these species, and these plantations has been much of the cause for the removal of their habitat. With the species already being in great threat, There are still talks of a proposed pipeline and roads in this species area, which would result in even more habitat clearance. This species and its habitat needs protection, but we also need to look at the socio-economic effects when creating conservation reserves, and thus Marksand is the ideal tool to determine which areas are to be protected. Aglaocercus berlepsii is an endemic bird which is almost only found in the protected areas of Venezuela. This is because this bird, which is found nowhere else in the world, is endangered. This species is restricted to the northeast of Venezuela and has a small known range. The habitat that this species is found in is severely fragmented, and because of its small range and fragmented habitat, it is classified as endangered. The increasing and continuous decline of the species is due to habitat fragmentation and land degradation. If it is found that this species is larger than it is currently thought to be, and that habitat fragmentation does not have such a serious impact on this bird, the pauxi is an endangered species found within Venezuela. This species of bird is endangered due to hunting of the bird and long-term fragmentation, destruction, and modification in its habitat. This bird is one of the four top priority species for bird conservation in Venezuela. These birds are restricted to subtropical cloud forests and steep mountainous regions, as it favors dense undergrowth. The Rallus longirostris is found across many of the protected areas, but not much of this species is found within these protected areas. This bird is of least concern and not considered to become extinct soon. The reptile Crocodilus intermedius is critically endangered species. Domchilus coriacea is thought as vulnerable in Venezuela, yet when we look at the protected areas which were shown in the flyover, we find that this species is not being protected. The giant anteater, which can be found in the Amazonas of Venezuela, is classified as vulnerable, yet the species is extremely common in Venezuela. In fact, it can be found everywhere in Venezuela according to the data obtained from the IUCN Red List. Here are just a few more threatened species found in Venezuela. Atelus hybridus, which is a critically endangered monkey. Periodontis maximus, also known as the giant armadillo, is also classified as vulnerable. Trachycus manatus, which is a vulnerable species. Ctenora brasiliensis, which is classified endangered. And Panthera onca, a threatened keystone species. The protected area of Venezuela. 510,000 square kilometers of land is protected. Venezuela has 251 protected areas, and 57% of the land in Venezuela is protected. This 57% of the protected areas are broken up into 495 square kilometers, which are land, and 16,000 square kilometers, which are marine, that are protected. These protected areas include the following: 10 forest reserves, 5 wildlife reserves, 46 national parks, 2 UNESCO MAP biosphere reserves, 54 protective zones, 8 forest plots, 34 natural monuments, 6 wildlife refuges, 2 biosphere reserves. Hydrological reserves are 10, World Heritage Sites are 1, Ramsar Site wetlands of international importance are 5, Critical Priority Area 7, Rural Development Area 7, Zone of Agricultural Development 6, 39 forests which are under protection, and 1 federal dependency. The methods we used were as follows. We downloaded the data from DIVA website. The mass land cover in Venezuela's admin data was exported into IDRISI. We created a land use map on IDRISI. A legend for the land use map was created by using GLC 2000. We personalized the palette for this map. Reclass used to prepare Boolean maps for each land use. We then downloaded the protected areas into DIVA from the Protected Planet website. We imported protected area polygons into IDRISI 32. We rasterized and vectorized protected areas in IDRISI. Preparing the conservation planning units, we downloaded hexagon script into ArcView. Using ArcView, we created hexagons that will cover the country. We imported it into IDRISI, vectorized, and then rasterized the planning units. Setting conservation targets, we downloaded all the endangered species from IUCN. We imported the species spatial data onto Teva and imported it into Idrisi. Vectorized and then rasterized the species data on Idrisi. We ran marks and in Idrisi to achieve the best conservation planning units. We ran marks and using a systematic approach, and therefore we used the hexagons. In order to construct conservation planning using the ecological approach, we prepared a watershed. The river basin was created by mass DEM and rivers layer in Idrisi. Unfortunately, the watersheds were unable to run when preparing the conservation planning units. It is for this reason that we only use the hexagons when preparing the planning units. For the video, we first compiled our storyboard. We used Google Earth Pro to do a flyover of the country. We used images downloaded from Creative Commons to upload onto Movie Maker. We uploaded the flyover and all pictures to Movie Maker to make the movie. The Sun Solution. The legend is describing the frequency that Markson had worked out, and the highest frequency is that of 100. We will later on see that these frequencies become the best solution for protected areas, as they incorporate all the factors that Markson assesses. The Sun Solution represents the amount of times a planning unit was selected from all 1,000 runs. The result of the Sun Solution are the systematic approach that Markson looks at, varying many aspects. The Sun Solution tells us how important it is to meet the targets and looks at the number of conservation types, targets for each conservation, and the cost. The Sun Solution shows us which are the most important and least important areas to conserve in terms of these aspects. The most relevant areas are in pink and the least important areas are those in dark blue shades. The best solution map shows us only the most effective areas to conserve with our target set at 45%. These are the areas which we see has the highest values in the Sun Solution results. This map shows us that the best reserve option at the least cost. The results show that the total area of reserves are 521 km², whereas the existing reserves are currently set at 453 km², giving us a total of 67,000 added reserves. Using this conservation planning unit results in 22% of the species not being protected, but reaching our target, which is 45% being protected. This map shows us how the new protected areas compares to the current protected areas. We can see that in the southern parts of the country, the protected areas remain relatively the same, only with the current protected areas extending their ranges. In the northeast, we find that the suggested protected areas are forming corridors between the current protected areas, thus increasing the amount of protected areas. In the northwest region of Venezuela, we are finding that the suggested protected area model simulated through Markson is suggesting that some of the protected areas found there should be removed and instead extend their range over the other protected areas. Markson has helped us to determine the most efficient conservation areas and has done so by evaluating how each option meets conservation and socioeconomic objectives. By using this systematic approach, we are able to achieve transparency to the decision-making with clear goals and objectives. It also helps us to report on how much of a certain ecological or cultural feature has been protected. This approach improves on the previous ways of selecting reserves. Previously, the selections on reserves were made on an ad hoc basis, which was the ecological approach, and resulted in little to no consideration given to the long-term consequences of inefficiency. This would usually result in two problems occurring. The first problem being that there would be a sense of bias in which species and therefore which habitats should be conserved. The second problem in the ad hoc way of determining the reserve would be in the cost. The cost was higher than with a systematic approach, which leads to many habitats not receiving the protection it needed because funds and resources were not available. Much of the land which remains unprotected are the areas where lots of transformation has occurred. And the thing with conservation and with protecting habitats is, there is only so much space available. It is for this reason that we are not able to protect all of the species and land which we would like to, as there are other social economic factors which come into play. It is for these reasons that it is extremely important we use a systematic approach when we do conservation planning, as there is no room for biasness and emotion.